Hello, everyone. It's time for our Saturday stream. The stream that, you know how it works. If you're watching this, you probably have been here before. You know how it works. We get together on Saturday nights. We play video games. Only the best video games. Our Ranger, am I afraid of ants? No, you're asking YouTube if they're afraid of ants. I could not say if YouTube is afraid of ants. Ants, you know, they're kind of annoying, but I don't think it's something really to be afraid of. But we're not streaming ants tonight. Unless you wanted me to. If you want, I could stream some ants and they would come pouring out of your USB ports right now. But that doesn't help either one of us. What about a million ants? What about a million DOS games, which is what we have to go through before we get to the end of the DOS archive. And we're continuing that on tonight. We're continuing on with some Willy Beamish, which froze on us last time round. Before we get to that, there's one thing I just want to go into, little unexpected thing to talk about. As I got a message in my Tumblr saying, "Dear Mr. Super Great Friend, would you be willing to do a shout-out for us? We've just launched a Kickstarter campaign to modernize using HTML5, Jeff Green's productions, Midnight Stranger, and Mode, something he decided to do in no small part to the LP you did of Mode. Check out Midnight Stranger on Kickstarter if you have time to take a look. We will release both for free, but the big plan is all to release the tools we develop so others can make new productions." Okay, so it was a message from Jeff Green. Jeff Green was the creator of Mode, which I did an LP of a while back. And it looks like he's interested in rebuilding his games to work on modern Windows. The first one being Midnight Stranger, and the second one is Mode. So I guess he hadn't thought about these games in some years and decided, hey, you know, go back to those and try to get them working on modern systems. But in addition, he also wants to create publicly usable tools so you can make your own Mode. Now, usually I don't really refer to Kickstarters. Oh, did Mode work on Windows 95? Someone is asking. It did indeed. It was a Windows 3.1 game and also worked on Windows 95, but it doesn't work on modern Windows. So, I usually don't refer to Kickstarters, but I figure that since I did play the game and there was a question at the end of that if, you know, Could these games actually be made public to modern PCs? I guess we'll go over that. So I just got this. Let's see. All right, here's the Kickstarter. It looks like it just started. No donations as of yet. The goal is 9,297. I thought that was an odd number, but then I saw down here it said 13,000 Canadian. So I figure what that's referring to, the reason I'm seeing a 9,000 number is because I'm seeing it in U.S. numbers. Let's get a little background music going on here, I guess. 31 days to go. Okay, so it's not a high... Oh, there actually is one backer now. There is actually not a high ceiling, so that's good, because crowdfunding is difficult. I hope Jeff Green understands this, that if you don't have a pre-existing audience when you're trying to kickstart something, it's not easy to get a bunch of people to give you money, because especially now, you know, there have been high-profile Kickstarters that didn't work out so well. Mighty Number 9. So people, you know, kind of a little mistrustful of some Kickstarters. So, I wish him luck. I hope it goes well. I guess we might as well watch the preview video while we're looking at this.
Hi, I'm Jeff Green, writer and director of Midnight Stranger, and this is my technical cohort on this amazing project, Mr. James Bott.
For some reason, I can't make it full screen.
Midnight Stranger.
Oh, there he goes.
No.
Play the video. Okay, there it goes.
And as computers have evolved over time, these productions...
Evil Wall asking, how does Midnight Stranger compare to Mode? It's the same kind of game. It plays the same way. Different storyline, but it is actually the same type of game.
What we want to do is take these productions and make them run on all of these modern platforms, whether it's a desktop or mobile, and then release these older titles free.
I can't wait to see Mode released on your Android tablet.
But maybe you should explain the...
Yeah, the... you see, when I first was offered the opportunity to do something like this, I really wanted to do the holodeck.
It's, I mean, that's ambitious, kind of a far cry.
I want that, obviously. The holy grail of media is that kind of virtual reality. But
with 1994 technology...
All I could really come up with was essentially a simulation.
I mean, it was a pretty distant simulation, but it was a good attempt.
It wasn't a good explanation.
This is the pitch video. I thought we were just going to do blue and green, and it doesn't make sense to put negative things in. Right, exactly.
See? Feeling better?
So the mood bar to me is at best a necessary evil. It's a shortcut. It's a way of achieving an interaction when you can't have full artificial intelligence.
This was a great idea because it actually allowed you to express a broad spectrum of reactions to something, and really, like in real life, you really wouldn't know how it would turn out.
I want to move on. It's still too limited.
So yeah, the mood bar.
Voice recognition.
As they're saying that you're supposed to have a very general reaction when you're clicking on the mood bar, so they don't have to actually try to anticipate every single kind of reaction you could have, just positive, neutral, or negative, even if the details might be different.
Either way, we are going to be creating a website where you can download or stream Midnight Stranger and any other productions that we do. And we're actually hoping that it kind of forms a hub so that other people can do other productions like this and make them available to a wider
audience.
That's
it. The tools, the capacity for the individual to download the authorware, shoot their own interactive production, upload it to our site. We're going to have a gallery. This is going to be a lot of fun.
We are trying to create a new genre.
Yes, when these things were first released, really what we were doing was simulating virtual reality. And that's what we want to do more of. We want to turn this into VR. We want to, let's get biofeedback. Let's get haptics. I mean, voice is just the beginning.
I want to put on my haptic response suit so I can go to the mode event in real time.
Please help us.
I think we're far away. We're not very close to that.
One of the things that we were doing when we were trying to put this together is we sat down and we said, you know, what is this? How do we describe this? What word do we use? And there was nothing. And so we call it other body experience.
An OBE. You're OBEing. It'll grow.
But...
We should, incentives.
Yeah, we should talk about the incentives.
Talk about the big one.
So anyone who donates $250 is going to be part of the world's first crowdsourced interactive drama.
I will contact each individual. We will co-create the character. We will shoot it through remote direction and remote recording, unless you're living nearby.
And then we're going to post it as really sort of the first new entry in this genre on our website.
Have we covered everything?
Well, I should describe the incentives, the
goals.
Yeah,
we could do a list of the goals. Yeah, there's no.
I know just what to do.
I don't get the end of this video, but that's how that ends. So. Okay, four more people have backed since we were watching that. Kind of an odd pitch video. I get that it was meant to be like a sort of a reference to actually playing the game-like mode, but it does kind of rely on you already knowing what that mood bar is supposed to be. Maybe could have done a better job explaining what this was. But let's see. Okay. What do they say about it? Let's go down. They talk about the mood bar. They talk about Midnight Stranger, released in 1994. I haven't played that one myself. Midnight Stranger is probably something that I've wanted to get to at some point, but I haven't gotten to it yet. Let's see. So, Midnight Stranger doesn't take place in a party. Rather, you're out in a town at night, and you're going to go into different locations, and you are talking with different people. Same kind of gameplay. Reviews were good. And actually, that's true. I had looked at this, like, back when I was doing mode, and it turned out that the response to Midnight Stranger was actually pretty positive. unlike Mode, in which like that there was like some pretty prominent negative review from PC Gamer, but it seemed like Midnight Stranger was reviewed actually quite well. And they refer to me because apparently that LP was the reason that Jeff Green got interested in this again. And the reason that he knew about the LP was because someone in the Something Awful LP thread tried to buy the game from Jeff Green and apparently referred to the LP. So that's how he found out about that. Yes, computer game enthusiast. That's what I do for a living. That's my profession. So they're doing this in HTML5 and JavaScript. Here's an animated GIF for you. So these are the two people, Jeff Green and his tech person, James Bott. Now we can experience a multi-sensory version of the information, which means a video. So I guess we're going to watch the video. I don't know what's going on with Kickstarter's video player. It's taking a while for actually... Okay, for anything to respond here. Like the volume.
I apologize right off the top. I'm having a few difficulties with the equipment in here. Whoa. Whew. Whoa. Oh, man. There it goes again. I'm awfully sorry about that. It feels strange. See, I let the shielding down in the studio, at least this part of the... The building a little
this is not part of the Kickstarter video. This is part of his Jeff Green's old TV series, I think. It's called Cowboy Who. I've never actually seen it, but I've seen references to it.
Don't worry, I can fix this.
Yes, Cowboy Who is on YouTube. It's on Jeff Green's channel. Oh my, James, don't flatter yourself. Pretty sure, yes, that he is on the cover of The Matrix. I'll have to look at that again. I think that is legit. I'll have to look at my DVD cover, but I'm pretty sure that he is actually on there.
Bring in the Mister.
You know, this is teaching me some valuable lessons when applying for work, that with your CV, it should be accompanied by a lot of dubstep. It will enhance your previous employment list. I'm pretty sure that's just standard for Canada, yes. That's how the Canadian... That's how job interviews are expected to go in Canada. You're expected to walk in, sit down, and then the beat drops. That's just standard procedure. This is educational. Anyway, that video's over. All right, what are the goals? Goal 1, Midnight Stranger, rebuilt. It says 13,000, but again, apparently that is Canadian. So, goal 1B... is that the tools are made publicly. Goal 1C is the online portal to post those things that you can make with the tools. Goal 1D is the first... I don't know if it's correct that this would be the first ever crowdsourced interactive drama. Granted, I have not seen many, but I can imagine there's probably something like that that's been made before. But anyway, they have stretch goals, which is Mode being rebuilt and posted. Goal B, Stranger Still... Which this didn't come out, I think. Stranger Still, it said that they made it using a customized binaural camera array designed for full screen delivery. Ooh, man. Can have full motion video now. But apparently that was not released. Let's see. Then they have a stretch goal for voice acting, but voice interaction, I think. where you would be interacting with your voice instead of using the mood bar, expensive acting talent, and all right, here's another video. This one's 136. Okay, let's see what this is. That is a wonderful looking webpage mock-up. It's very clear looking at that what you're supposed to do on that page. So I guess you could probably describe this as they want to make like Game Maker, but for full motion video games? Right, like Midnight Stranger mode, only playable when Windows 3.1 and Windows 95. You can't play it on Windows 7. You know, I think that these games could probably do okay on Android. Like, the interface probably is all right for, like, mobile tablets. Would I make a game with an FMV creator? I don't know. I'd have to think if they actually made this, I'd probably want to try something. I don't know what it would be. Anyway, here's an animated GIF. What do we get for donating? Okay. Oh, another video about incentives. Let's watch this. This one is 7 minutes? I don't think we're going to watch this whole thing. Let's go through it. We're just going to skim through this, I think. SGF's Pro Wrestling Adventure. I can imagine, yes, making a Pro Wrestling FMV game. Who's that? Who's that? Oh, my God! All right, this is a stretch goal right here, apparently. I'm not sure how we got to this.
So, you're feeling hungry. Gonna cordless food processing system. You may never get in any store. Send just 89.
So yeah, stretch goals. There you go.
New York, 16283. Or call the number that is not appearing on your screen and they'll tell you to send 89.95 to HS Box 1, etc. Act now. This offer could end.
You know, if Jeff Green had made an FMV game that was basically that, probably would have done okay. He explains the logo here. Why is it on its side? Let's go down. Let's see. Oh yeah, he also mentions an OBE is not a game because, like, in mode, there was no competition, no way to win, no scores kept. It's about socializing and role-playing. Let's see. Is logo a man or a woman? It says that it can be seen as many things. Many see a person in prayer. So I guess, like, here are the arms curved in front of the person. But it could be any. It's whatever you want it to be. Short profile of Midnight Stranger. There's 11 minutes of mode. Stranger still. And yeah, the last thing I wanted to look at was they said that they had this tech demo done. This proof of concept that Midnight Stranger would work in HTML5. So here's a person. I am going to say blue.
I don't know. Would you like to walk me over there? It's not very far away. It'd be great.
Sure, I will walk you over there.
Well, let's go then.
No, I don't want to go now.
Well, I should go. So it was nice chatting with you, but I should get back.
Yes, I will go now.
Would you like to walk me over there?
All right, I guess that it's only those choices. So it's not the entire scene, it's just basically showing that, yeah, you could have FMV playing while you can click on reactions here. Let's see, menu button and help button, so those don't do anything right now. Is this from a game? This is from Midnight Stranger, I think. You can see it's the same interface as Mode, but it is a different game. So yeah, that is her neck cut. Look, haven't you watched Mode? It's like a little FMV window in... Oh, I forgot. Don't say reactions. Yes, that's correct. I'm sorry. Jeff Green should know about that. We cannot actually have any reactions at all to Midnight Stranger because people own that, and we cannot infringe on people's copyright. We cannot react at all to any of this. Razio, they have the space to fit all the video. They do, but apparently what they're doing is rebuilding the, well, porting, I should say, the existing game to modern Windows and mobile devices. They're not actually remaking the game using the original footage. I don't know if they have the original footage. I mean, if they did, and if it was possible to remake Mode using the original footage in HD, I would love that, but I don't know if they even have that. So yeah, that is Jeff Green's Kickstarter for remaking Midnight Stranger and possibly Mode. Someone asking, CJY Takagi, if this gets backed, will I play Midnight Stranger? Yes, I would play Midnight Stranger if this got backed. I would be interested in doing that and seeing how this turned out. He also says that he's going to make an online portal that has the tools to make your own FMV game in this style if this got backed. So that's like the main thing, I think, that you would be looking at with a Kickstarter like this, like making public tools like that. Will I donate? Yeah, I'll donate to this. I mean, I don't know if it's going to get backed because it's like I said, this, it's hard to kickstart games if you don't have a pre-existing audience. That is difficult. And I hope that they are actively trying to court support for this instead of hoping that people will just find it on Kickstarter, because that doesn't happen, you know? It doesn't happen that people just come across these things and decide, I will contribute to it. But it was something like 9,000 something to actually get the whole thing backed. I hope it makes it, but we'll see how it goes. They have an existing audience. It's me. God, I hope I'm not the only one they're relying on to actually make this thing happen. Because that is, don't count on that, Jeff Green. I mean, I am showing it, but don't count on that being the thing that is going to fund this. But I will contribute to this myself. But anyway, that is the Kickstarter, and like I said, most of the time I do not show Kickstarters, but since during the Mode LP I was very interested in knowing if it was possible for Mode to get re-released, and since the entire reason apparently that Jeff Green got interested in doing this again was because of that LP, I feel that I should probably show this. So here it is. I'll probably come back to this as it is going on to see how it's doing. Anyway, that is the Kickstarter. You can go to Kickstarter and search for Midnight Stranger if you're interested on this. Can I plug this on the SA forum and not get banned? Probably not, because that Mode thread, that's gone. That's long gone. There'd be no reason to really post this on the SA forum. So I don't know if that would be legit. Let's move on. Oh, not to Aldo's adventure yet. We will get there, but we're not doing that yet. Somebody may be able to post it on GBS. Maybe, but I think that if they wanted to get support, it would have to be to the people who actually were following the Mode thread. And maybe I could post it as the final post to the Realms of the Haunting thread. Maybe I could do that. And we'll see. That's the Kickstarter. We'll come back to that and see how it's doing as the month goes on. Yeah, I do think that in terms of putting together a slickly packaged proposal for Kickstarter, I think that, you know, maybe they have a little bit to learn about doing that, but if they were actually able to get funded and make that happen, make the Midnight Stranger remake happen, not remake, I should say port, and if they were able to make those public tools available, I would play Midnight Stranger, and I would try to make something with the tools, but good luck to them, you know? I hope you make it. I don't know if you will. But that's for later. Would I play it on Android? I'd see how it turned out on Android. I imagine that would probably be actually the best platform, since you're just tapping on the screen, right? Probably. Okay, let's go to DOSBox, because we are continuing on. Would I kiss Jeff Green if the Kickstarter got funded? I mean, if that was a stretch goal that people wanted to donate to, I mean, I have to fly to Canada, so that probably would be kind of expensive. Let's play Willy Beamish. Instead of talking about me kissing Jeff Green on the mouth, maybe we could play Willy Beamish. What happened last time in Willy Beamish? Well, last time, the game crashed. It froze. And I don't know why it did, but wait, on the mouth? Look, I'm assuming that if you want to see me kiss him, it's going to be on the mouth. But I am not making any promises. Last time in Willy Beamish, it froze. Oh, hold on. I think I have to turn the sound on. Let me just see. Sound off? Yeah, there it is. All right, so, okay, it crashed last time, but fortunately, one thing that turned out was that in this past week, I had tried to go through that scene again, and it actually froze a whole bunch of times, but I finally got through it. I finally got through that scene and was able to actually save the game after dinner. So we've made it past that. Yes, that's right. Dinner is over. Okay, this is right after dinner. And I think we have to mow the lawn. That's what happened next.
I want you to go mow the lawn now, son. I'll even throw in a couple of bucks for you.
Yeah, we'll do it.
Oh, all right.
So I had restarted the game, and at this point, I think what we've done is, I took the diary, and I fiddled with the sister's scale, and I fixed the cut on the finger with the iodine and the Band-Aid. I didn't try to steal the report card. I left it in the mail slot. So I think that's where we're at this point. That's right, I also lost my Game Boy. I lost my Game Boy because I went into the bathroom where Spider was, and I gave him the Game Boy so he wouldn't punch me through the door. Let's see, my stalker is telling me if I want to know how to get the Nintari. Yeah, I think probably we should figure out how to get through this first part of the game, doing everything we need to do, so we don't have to come back here, because we've gone through this first part pretty quickly. I mean, not quickly. A few times, I should say. We've gone through it a few times. Let's see. I think we're going to head upstairs then. Yes, you have to use Horny on your sister.
I need you. I'm in the tub and I'm out of conditioner.
Willy, take your sister a bottle of conditioner.
Do I have to?
Just do it. I'm busy.
Yeah, Willy, don't complain about every single thing anyone ever says. This is why they send you to military school. Someone asked if I'm playing this on the Sega CD. No, this is the DOS version. This is the DOS CD version, which means it has voice acting. The diskette version does not have voice acting. I assume that the Sega CD version has CD music and not the ad-lib music that we're hearing here, but I've never actually played that version. Okay. We gotta go into the bathroom. And let's see, and we have actually no qualms, apparently, about coming in on our sister in the bath. Let's get the frog out. And here we go.
Get that thing out of here! Oh, gross! Ma!
I All right. Like, we did that.
Get out!
Oh, wait. Is that the key?
Horny! Jump her if she moves a finger!
You won't get away with this, punk.
Wait, so she just sees us take it? Like, isn't that besides the point? I mean, won't she just tell our parents that we took the key?
It's locked! But hey, I have the key!
The key to what, someone asks? It is the key to the Nintari, because it comes with a lock and key. And now we have the key, so now we can unlock it and play Nintari. Logic worked differently back in the 90s, says Justin. Look, I guess I do not understand extreme 90s logic. Thinking about it, someone did release a peripheral for the NES back in the day where you could lock it. Like, that actually did exist. Like, it was a lock that went into the cartridge slot, so...
I just know I can win the championships now!
So you couldn't put a cartridge in there. That did exist, so I guess that's what this kind of thing is referring to. Anyway, I guess we've practiced enough. I guess? I wonder if we're supposed to be doing something else? Oh, save the game? You're probably right. I should probably save.
Help me, what? Willy! I fell in my key.
Well, that line got cut off. Okay, let's help you up, I guess.
Thanks, Willy. Yeah, well, don't think I like you all of a sudden. You're still a girl. I'm just trying to get our mom's good side.
I don't know why we're so hateful to our younger sister. It's like, I get that the older sister and Willy antagonize each other, but we are, like, horrible to our younger sister, and I can't figure out why. Anyway, I should save the game. I wonder if there's anything else we should be doing.
Here.
Okay. I guess we don't hear her phone conversation this time. She's just had enough of us. Someone asking, why would the save icon be a CD? I have no idea. You cannot save to the CD. It makes no sense that would be the case. Anyway, if I remember last time, eventually we go to bed, and then we start off the next day, and then we can leave the house. So I don't remember if there was anything else we actually needed to do in the house at this point. We might have finished everything out. Maybe check the dog again? Alright, we'll talk to the dog. The save icon is a CD because it tries to save to the CD drive, remember? It does, and I have no idea why it defaults to the CD drive. Here's the dog.
I'm a lucky dog to have such a nice master like Willy.
I mean, all dogs love their masters. Like, you are without flaw in the eyes of your pet dog. So, I don't think the dog is a very good judge of Willy's character. Oh, we're telepathic? Yes, we can read the mind of the dog. Also remember that Willy can see the ghost of his dead grandfather. So, Willy is psychically sensitive. He probably doesn't know it. He probably doesn't have, you know, a word to describe what it is that he's seeing. But yeah, apparently he has ESP. Dad didn't pay us for mowing the lawn. I think we have the money. Hold on. It was in the inventory. Yeah, here it is.
Money!
I'm pretty sure that came from the mowing the lawn.
Willy,
we didn't have
close to bedtime.
All right, here we go. Two whole bucks? Well, I mean, that is what the father said he would give us. He said he would give us a couple bucks, and he did. Oh man, a $2 bill. Those were hard to find, even in the early 90s. Yeah, I had a $2 bill. I never spent it, just because it's a $2. I mean, that's weird.
Good night, buddy. See you in the morning. I wonder what Grandpa meant when he said something funny was going on in Frumpton.
Oh well, I guess it's nothing we have to be concerned about.
Good night, Willy.
Even though things we've fallen on hard time, Dad still cares. Do I have to click something? First day of summer vacation, and it's time to boogie. Alright, so if I remember right, the first thing that we do is we can leave the house, and then we have the possibility of...
I think I'll stop by the tree fort and see what's going on.
Yeah, we can go to the tree house. And I do have the diary, so we can make the deal. The dark deal.
Morning, Dad. Hi, Brianna.
Yep, I know how he feels.
Really? And I want some cereal.
You know, I am just gonna say let's not get in trouble by yelling at our sister in front of our father.
Sure, Brianna. What do you want? Honey roasted kooky clowns or fiber squares?
Ooh, I want honey roasted kooky clowns. Lots of them.
How old and Willy are Willy?
I'm hungry too.
Are Willy and Brianna? I believe that we, like in a previous stream, we noted that Willy was finishing fifth grade, which probably means he's around 10. Yeah. Let's be a good kid and feed the dog.
All right, boy. I'll get you some food.
So, you know, he's just about old enough to start going on his Pokemon journey.
I want to watch Space Noids from Cybernet. It's on next.
Well,
I mean... Ponytail.
What are you reading, Dad?
The want ad, son. I gotta find a job ASAP.
See anything interesting?
Actually, there is one.
That's right, the job that they're looking for a patsy for at Tootsuite.
Sounds perfect, Dad. You gonna call him?
What have I got to lose?
Can I click through scene content? Yeah, I mean, we've been through the scene where Gordon tries to act all smooth when talking to the CEO of Tootsuite. And you know, you wouldn't think that when you call a corporation like that, that it would be the CEO picking up and talking to the job seeker directly. But maybe she's just really hands-on when it comes to hiring personnel. Because, you know, that's probably a good way of doing it. You want to be very aware of who it is your company's hiring.
Leona.
You don't want to hire people who, you know, it turns out that it was a bad decision, because it can be difficult sometimes to get rid of that person if it turns out that, oh no, we didn't do our due diligence and it turns out this person is a disaster.
All right,
Can you keep it down, Dad?
I want to see them.
Dad, I don't care about your job. I want to watch the cartoons. Right, and we have to enter the frog jump competition, so which is probably going to be how we get the money to get to the Nintari Championships. Pretty sure that fly was outside of the TV. Oh, right, that's right. We have to get our female friend, because she has a frog who apparently is very, apparently Horny is very motivated by. So apparently that's where we're gonna get Horny to be a lot faster than the other frogs?
Hold it down, kids. I want to see this.
By getting the girl frog to be in the race, or do something with the girl frog. I'm not really sure what it is we're gonna be doing.
Shake it. You can freeze it. You can bake it. Any way you use it. With Toot Sweet, you're sure to lose it.
Oh, right. The nightmarish mascot for Toot Sweet. I forgot about that.
Such a pudge. Go on.
Watch out as Toot Sweet shambles after you, trying to force itself into your mouth. Basically, it's like Deadly Premonition, if it catches up with you.
I can't believe it! I have an interview.
We have an interview. That's right, I forgot.
Not so fast, pal. What do you think I am, made out of money?
We are not made out of money.
You know, when I was a boy...
I've heard that story.
Everybody's gotta pull their own...
Well, right, we have to wash the car. All right, let's just try not to get in trouble.
Okay. I suppose you want a hot wax, too.
Just a wash, that's all.
Consider it done.
Right, and his car ends up being absolutely filthy, because...
Not how I imagined myself spending the summer.
Like, I guess when he commuted to work, he would take, like, a detour through a swamp. I guess that was a shortcut, so the car needed to be cleaned? Alright, so, I think we can leave now. And I will save first. Alright, the answering machine? I think these would just be the messages that we already heard the last time we played, because I didn't click through them when I started this game up, so I don't think it's anything new there. Alright, let's just head out. Let's try to actually make some progress. Because we haven't made a whole lot of that in this, as we've been trying to play this game. Okay, so let's go to the tree fort. Head up there. And say, yo, to our crew and make the deal as we trade away our sister's private thoughts for our own material gain.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, Willy, where you been?
Hi, Willy. By the way,
thanks.
All right.
Got a can of slam dunk for me?
Just ran out, man.
Got any more gum?
Get any good baseball cards?
I never get the good ones, just the rookies. Hey, what's this?
It's a Mickey Morris! There's only 12 of them in the whole world!
Give it to me. I need it.
Man. I want that card. You gotta give it to me.
Or else.
What do you give me for it?
Your life.
Well, we already know what we have with us.
Let's see what I have with me.
Don't mess with me, Perry. You have no idea how important this is to me.
Anyway, we have the diary.
Tiffany's diary? What would I want that for?
Don't think I don't know, you freak.
There's diary. Diary's supposed to be private. Boys.
I would trade both of you for the money to get to the championships.
Look, you might learn something. Here, let me read you a sample. May 12th. Cliff is so tender and loving, and his pants are so tight.
Uh-oh, sounds like your sister really has a hot for this guy. Read some more, Willie.
May 15th. We kissed so long, I thought I was gonna get lockjaw.
This is great stuff. You got a deal, Willie.
I knew this was your thing, Perry. I knew you were into this. Give it to me.
Okay, give me the card.
You guys make me sick.
Hey, what's that?
I named her Gigi. What do you think of her?
Right, so Horny is really into Gigi, so...
Am I in heaven or what?
So there's probably gonna have to be something where we have to get, like... Maybe at the toad race, we have to get Gigi on the finish line so Horny will see her there and, like, make a beeline to the finish line. Like, I can imagine that's probably going to be how this is going to go. And why did she put lipstick on the frog? I guess that was just the style at the time. Makeup on your pet? Sure, why not?
Are you crazy? Gigi's a shelf frog.
Look at him jump! Look at Horny go!
Gigi doesn't need to prove anything. All you boys ever think about is winning.
There isn't anything else but winning.
Anyway, let's see. That's, what did we pick last time? A frog jump isn't for any run-of-the-mill wimpy girl frog. It'll be a lot of fun. Without Gigi, Horny doesn't seem motivated enough. We tried two last time, and it didn't work. Alright, so if we tried the second one last time, I guess we should go with one.
You're right. Winning isn't everything. Besides, the frog jump isn't for any run-of-the-mill wimpy girl frog. A frog's gotta have guts and determination if he's gonna win $25,000 and a trophy.
Who are you calling wimpy? Gigi can jump with the best of them.
I don't know, Dana. I heard Turbo Frog has won so many times, he's gonna be on the cover of Sports Illustrated.
What? Turbo Frog is gonna be in this? No one told me about that.
Big deal. My Gigi is poetry in motion. She's got it all. Brains, brawn, and beauty. I bet she could even beat Horny.
There's nothing like a little competition to get my juices flowing.
Gigi doesn't need to prove anything to you boys. I'm not gonna sell out and put her in a dumb old contest.
Fine, if that's how you feel. But I'm sure Horny will do a lot better if Gigi's in the contest.
I'm sorry, but that's how I feel. Hey, sports fans, I'm kinda hungry. Wanna go over to the Slice of Life and get a pizza? I got a free coupon.
That's right, and the next thing we were doing was gonna go to the pizza place. Was there anything we could look at, though?
You can't budget. The dart is stuck.
That's an odd reading. I don't know if this is just leaving if I click this. Oh no, we got this. It's a comic. I'm gonna take the comic.
Comic book. Holy Pulp Magazine. It's Biffo Man comic book.
Save while I can? Yeah, probably should.
Baseball card. A 1990 Mickey Morris.
Considering this game came out in the early 90s, would a baseball card that came out in 1990 really be worth anything? Whoop, I dropped it. Huh. Oh, no, there it is. Okay, I still have it.
A 1990 Mickey Morris.
Let's just put that back in there. Yeah, they said they only made 12, but still, I don't think it would be worth anything if it just came out. I don't think baseball cards or collectibles in general work that way. I cannot save the game right now. All right, hold on. Get out of this. Can I save it now? There we go. And as Willy thought he would like some pizza, he realized that there was an emptiness within himself that didn't have anything to do with hunger, didn't have anything to do with his stomach. He realized that when he traded away his sister's diary, he also traded away a piece of his soul. But it would be worth it. The only way to fill that missing part of his soul would be to win the Nintari Championships. And then he would finally be complete. I guess we should leave. When Pokemon cards were popular, I had a friend that bought his Charizard for $100. But those are playing cards, and someone who really wants a good card, who's really into that game, might be willing to spend a lot of money on it. Baseball cards, you don't do anything with them. They're pure collectibles. They have no function or use.
Hey, fellas, how about a romantic picture of you and the little lady?
Think of it. The three of us immortalized forever. Anyone have a dollar?
I'm tapped out.
So, we made a vote last time, and we went for the picture. I guess I'll take another vote on that. Do you want us to use a dollar for a picture? I mean, we might need it? I don't actually know if we need the photo, or if we will need the dollar. So, I haven't actually read any walkthrough or anything to see if that's the case. But it looks like people are overwhelmingly vote for option number 2. So we're going to do that. We're going to say, I have a dollar.
I do. Here, mister.
Okay, everyone. Look at the birdie. I think you're going to like this one. Here you go, young fella. Something for your scrapbook. Thanks, kids.
And as the game goes on, eventually we all fade away from that photo as we lose parts of ourselves to our hubris and our ambition. All right. Looks like we're eating. Can we do...
Whoa. I don't remember this stuff being so spicy.
Sure does have a kick to it. This pizza goes well with slam dunk cola, though.
Maybe we should have stuck with the basic pepperoni instead of the anchovy olive surprise.
We don't eat something that's described as a surprise.
You get what you pay for.
Man, am I paying for this? I feel like I'm gonna explode.
I forgot about this very humorous part.
It wasn't me either.
Well, we could see that the sound effect came from Willy.
P.U.
Oh, gross! I think it was that guy over there. You ruined my lunch, creep.
Uh-oh, I feel another wave coming on.
So we died here last time.
Don't you know breaking wind is bad table manners? Scuzzballs like you deserve to be punished.
It's true Willy didn't even try to hold it in.
Quick! Not so fast, fart face.
Alright, so... I think we chose one last time, and it resulted in us being murdered. That's what happened, right? Oh, we chose two? Okay, so... Well, if we chose two, and that... If people are sure that we chose two, then I'm going to choose one this time.
Let me go. I'm warning ya. Get out of my face.
All right. One of those choices resulted in our death, and the other one resulted in him just letting us go.
So don't touch anything, Sonny. And don't use the last doll over there. Had to pour the turpentine down the toilet.
Shouldn't you put up a wet paint sign?
Ran out of them on my last job. No smoking is all I got left. Same difference.
Yeah, I guess so. I can see that. All right, what can we do here? No, I didn't want to click on that. Oh, I can take the no smoking sign. For some reason.
No smoking sign. C. Everett Koop would be proud.
I don't know why we need that. Doesn't seem like there's anything else.
Notice the poor design for this poster. The word yum is not completely visible. In a recent survey, only 5% of Slice of Life customers were able to figure out that the hidden letter is M.
Oh, hey, Spider. You just come in here to murder us anyway.
Butthead, you stunk up the whole joint. Now I'm gonna rearrange your face.
Sorry, man. It just sort of happened. It was an accident.
You're an accident waiting to happen if you don't give me something out of your backpack.
Alright. Let's see what we can give him.
See what I have in here.
You know, I think maybe he could really use this no smoking sign.
No smoke.
Don't do it. Don't give him the sign. Will he murder us if we give him the sign? We should give him the card. Alright, if... I guess I'll... Hold on. Take this.
This sucks. Here's what you get for holding back on me.
He doesn't like it. Yep, he just punched us right through the wall.
Here's my diagnosis, nurse. First of all, there's a nasty dog leg. Then there's this aggravating slice. What a handicap! What am I going to do about the putts?
Doctor, right, the, what on earth?
The doctor really likes golf. That's
my
right.
Golf game.
All right, so let's go back and hang with the crew. Oh, I give him the comic book? Let's see, let's make sure that I have the comic book here. Yeah, I got it. So, I guess we should leave and go to the pizza place and,
later.
I guess do exactly what we did before, except give him the comic book this time. Yes, buy photo, take sign, give comic. That's what we're doing so far.
I do. Here, mister.
Okay, everyone. There you go.
Whoa.
Sure does. Maybe we should.
No wonder this joke.
You get what you. Man.
Braffet.
It wasn't me.
It wasn't. He who smelled.
We're doomed to relive this fart forever. Yes, this is Willy's hell. He just has to keep doing this over and over and over again. Like Sisyphus pushing the boulder. Willy is doomed to continually eat the pizza. And then be murdered by Spider.
Don't you know, break? I gotta get. Not so.
Alright, it was choice one.
Let me go! I'm warning ya!
Get out of my...
All right, let's head to the bathroom. Let's take the sign.
Walls are still a little...
Shouldn't you...
Ran out of a...
Now, let's see. I wonder if we can leave. Oh no, he comes in anyway.
Nice. Sorry, man. You're an Let's see what I have in here.
Alright, let's give him the comic.
Biffo Man! My favorite!
I recommend the last stall. It has the best lighting.
Oh, Spider's not all bad. He still has something inside of him that remembers what it's like to be a child and to have these simple pleasures.
Forget the pizza! We've got to get out of here or I'm finished!
Or we could just take the pizza with us.
Meanwhile...
Oh, he's smoking?
No!
Did Willy expect that he would be smoking? So he just told him to go into the stall to kill him?
Let's just say I have a hunch Spider's gonna give up smoking in the near future.
And living, too! Pizza.
Sure was. I really enjoyed it.
Are you gonna come down and watch the frog jump, Perry?
I wouldn't miss it, but you need to make sure you head down to West Frumpton tomorrow and fill out an entry blank for the contest at Tootsuite Pavilion.
I heard the ferry will be running again by then.
Why isn't it running now?
My dad said that Gus ran the USS Dumpling aground on a sandbar again.
I think Gus is kind of weird. Once he told me that he was wounded in the war and they had to put a metal plate in his head.
I bet he has a heck of a time with the metal detectors at the airport.
Oh, he's not so bad. I even trade baseball cards with him, sometimes.
Just the same, I'm glad he's not piloting oil tankers in Alaska for a multinational petroleum company.
Oh, timely early 90s reference. All right, let's save. And I just wanted to, just confirm that, okay, yes, the reason we took the no smoking sign was because we know that Spider smokes, and we knew that the toilet had turpentine in it, and that was the one that we recommended that he sit in, so we were actually deliberately trying to get Spider exploded. Just wanted to confirm that. Anyway, is there anything else we can do in here? Oh, we can talk.
Hey, how about we all go to the park and let the frogs practice jumping?
Okay, that sounds super.
All right, I guess let's head out. Did I buy the picture? Yes, we do have the picture.
We just have to figure out a way to beat Turbo Frog's record 25-footer.
Or maybe we could break Turbo Frog's legs. It would be so easy. Frog's legs are so thin.
I should probably... I guess what I'm expected to do here is use Horny? On the thing? No? Can I not use him on the thing? Oh, there it is. Okay. Not good enough, Horny.
But it won't beat Turbo Frog.
Gee, Horny never jumped that far before.
Gigi's never been around before, either.
It's just not good enough.
Not bad, but it won't beat...
All right. What are you looking at, sir?
Hey, okay! What'll it be? I've got slam dunk for a buck.
is your job just to be a human vending machine? Like, they could have just put a machine here instead of you being here, sir.
Nice day for some jumping practice, eh, Willy?
I think Horny's got eyes for Gigi.
Yeah, I think that's what's going on here. Okay, so... we do have the dollar. Do we... yes, I am shaming his job, his human vending machine job. Should we buy the soda? I mean, we have the $1, and I suppose probably that Willy wants the slam dunk. I mean, maybe we need the dollar for something else. A frog would die if you gave it caffeinated soda. If we only knew where Turbo Frog was. If only we could get it to drink the soda.
I'll take a bottle of that stuff.
That'll be $1. Bring back the bottle when you're done. I recycle it.
Maybe I will recycle it. Ever think of that, sir?
Slam dunk coda. Uh-huh. You got the right one, maybe.
Soda catchphrases. All right,
I bet Gigi can jump farther than Turbo Frog.
Earlier in the day, two kids used chalk to make distance markers for determining how far their frogs jumped in comparison to Turbo's world record of 25 feet.
But none could compare. You want me to give the soda to the frog? All right. Probably should save before I do that, I'm gonna guess. All right, we're doing it. Oh man, that cola is frog steroids.
Wow, that was amazing.
What's in this stuff? I hope it's nothing toxic.
Yeah, I mean, we hope. We don't know. I guess it's okay. All right, so we've done that.
We can't stay here too long. The sun's bad for Gigi's complexion.
The frog complexion.
Let's get on with it, Willy.
I mean, we've already done it. Do we need to do something else?
Not bad, but...
I know, we've been through that. Do I take the frog? I don't really see anything else to do here.
During hot summer days, Willy and Perry can often be found on the fountain's top level, spitting water out of their mouths.
Oh, that's delightful. Recycle the bottle? Oh yeah, we still have some. I mean, it looks like this still has soda in it. I don't think... should we give it to him? It doesn't look empty. I didn't give the frog the whole bottle. Well, yeah, but would we need to give the frog the whole bottle? We probably need it for the contest. It doesn't seem like there's really anything else to do here. We've figured out how we can drug the frog to get it to jump to beat Turbo Frog's record. So since we've done that, is there anything else we need to do?
See you guys later.
See you, Willy.
Oh, yeah, we could probably just leave. I'm assuming I'm going to take the frog with me. Yeah, there we go.
Okay, Tiff. Now push in the clutch and start the motor.
The enigmatic cliff has finally appeared.
The floor to your left.
Oh my, what's this thingy, Bob?
That's the gear shift. Okay, Tiff. Now ease her into reverse.
Wait, stop!
Nice driving, Tiff.
Oh, teen drivers. Where am I? It doesn't see. I'm looking around to see. Oh, what if I click on the top? What happens there? Did we just yell at her from the park? Nice driving, sis. How did we even see that happen? Okay, yeah, here's the town. It's like a castle there. What is that?
There are two ways to get to Humford Mansion: via a private road or by water. To be open to you at the moment.
All right, that's probably like the last level. We can't get there now. All right, can we take the coin? I guess. How expansive is this town? I don't know how large this game is. I don't see it here. Hold on. Did I not actually pick it up? Yeah, I guess we didn't. Oh, here we go. I forgot to put the coin in Willy. Yes, Willy needs the coins for sustenance. It's what he lives on. Put your money directly inside Willy.
Ferry token. Good for a one-way trip on the Frumpton Ferry.
Oh, it's not a coin, it's a token. So if we need to take the ferry, we can do that. Save and try taking the other coin. All right. Yes, a one-way trip. You don't need to come back. Ever.
Freeze, punk. I thought I'd overlook it the first time, but repeat offenders go to jail in this town.
Even if you're 10. And no one ever saw Willy again. Juvie, what's that? No, there is no juvenile hall. All offenders go to the same jail. Doesn't matter how old you are. Did his sister go to military school? I guess we should probably go back home and see if his sister is going to get sent to military school. Oh, here's something new.
Like these shirts? I have them on special this week. Only $5. They're all cotton. If you have a picture, it would only take a second to transfer it to a shirt. They make a great gift. And the colors are so lifelike. It won't bleed, run, shrink, or fade, and you can wash it 1,000 times.
All right, so I could get a photo of Willy and his friends? I mean, I don't know if I have the money for that, but let's see if we can do it. We don't have the money, right?
Can you turn this picture into a t-shirt?
Let's see if we can. No?
Back again, huh? I knew you'd see what a great deal these t-shirt transfers are. Give me the picture and I'll get started.
Oh, I should give the picture first.
Sure.
Here you go. Came out perfect. Want three more? I'll give you another 10% off. Six more, 15% off. Buy a dozen and I'll take 20%. Want a gross? I'll save you even more.
Yes, I think we'll start mass selling these shirts commercially. Everyone will want a Willy and his friends t-shirt.
T-shirt. Made from 100% natural fibers. You can wash it 1,000 times.
But don't you dare wash it 1,001 times. You don't want to know what happens. All right, let's check the machine.
On the lottery machine says, out of order.
I mean, I guess we can actually still interact with it.
Maybe there's some money in the coin slot.
Oh, Willy. Let's see if we can get anything. Hmm? What's that? Frumpton bucks. Oh, it's a lottery ticket.
Lottery ticket! 6, 7, 13, 26, 31. Bonus number, 49.
Willy trying all the angles to raise this money to get to the Nintari Championships. Okay, I guess we can't actually go into that store. And the only exit is on the left. I guess I'm gonna head back. Pillow's asking what this game is. This is The Adventures of Willy Beamish, a delightful DOS point-and-click adventure game of the worst family who has ever lived. You will hate every character in this game. Anyway, let's look at the car crash. Let's see, can I go over there? Go to the fountain? All right, I'll go to the fountain. I don't know why I would need to be here.
I just gotta figure out a way to get Horny to beat Turbo Frog's record 25-footer.
Well, we already worked that out. I don't think there's anything else for us to be here for. It doesn't seem like I can actually click on the car crash. I gotta go fill out the form. Did we see anywhere else to go to that we could do that to? Go to the clubhouse? Alright, let's head over there. See if anything is happening. Oh, the form is tomorrow, so we can't do that yet. Oh, show them the shirt. That's true. We do have the shirt now, and I guess they would be interested in seeing what we've done with this.
It's the three of us. Three best friends. You can wash it 1,000 times.
Oh, Willy, it's beautiful. I'll wear it for the rest of my life.
And only this.
Friendship is more important than winning a dumb old frog jump contest. Well, I better get moving.
Willy's friends knew that he didn't actually believe that.
Best friends gotta stick together. Gigi will show him what she can do.
Oh, okay. So I guess that was what we were doing. Getting her to join the frog competition. Alright, so I guess it was because we gave the shirt, now she believes that we are really friends and that Willy is not actually just using her to get what he wants. Like, Willy uses everyone.
Hey, how about we all go to the park and let the frogs practice jumping? Okay.
What?
Willy,
no, let's not do that.
Great idea.
No, we don't need to do that. I guess there's really nothing else to do at this point. How has Willy used his mother? He hasn't really figured out a way to do it, but don't you think that Willy would not take advantage of his mother if he could figure out how?
See you guys later.
See you, Willy.
Oh, there's another item in Willy's room that I still need to get.
See you, Willy.
All right, let's check out Willy's room and see if we can find anything in there. That car is still a wreck. Where is Perry's frog? Perry doesn't seem to have a frog. I guess he's not into that scene, the pet frog scene. All right, let's go into Willy's room. Will we somehow get in trouble for our sister's crash? I wouldn't be surprised if there was some way that Willy could be blamed for it. Alright, let's look around the room and see if our cursor does anything. We could go to bed, but I don't think we need to do that right now. Get some flies? What? Okay, over here. Alright.
Jar with flies. Just the thing for a hungry frog.
Are we a lord of them? I can imagine Willy doing well in the Lord of the Flies. He would hold up the conch and rule all that he surveys. I've already practiced Nintari. I don't know if we actually need to keep doing that. So is there actually anything else that we can find or anything good that's going to happen if we keep looking around the house or leaving the house, I wonder? Or should we just go to bed? Go talk to Dad? All right, let's go around and talk to the family. Alright, so what does our sister think about her first car accident?
Hey, Tiff! Get out of here!
Apparently, we cannot talk to her about it. The symbolism of the conch is that it ends up losing any authority or meaning. So I wonder if Willy would be the one to wield the conch, or would he be the one to overthrow it? Instead of a conch, it's of course it's an Antari. Nothing around so far. Let's make a loop around the house and see if we can find anyone to talk to. Does Willy need 25k to get to the Nintari contest? Not 1,000. I think he needed 2,500. I believe that's what the amount was. Oh, we can go down here? I don't think I realized that. Oh, this is the backyard. Can I talk to the guy that Dana was driving with? Cliff does not seem to be available. I don't see him around anywhere.
It's great to be free from the ravages of intelligence.
Ah, bliss. When will we see Cliff's tight pants? I mean, I guess the game does have to save something for later. All right, so I guess for right now, that's probably a good enough for the adventures of Willy Beamish. I guess we'll just continue on and see in the coming weeks if we can make some more progress, because we did pretty well tonight. We got through like a part that we have not been able to get through before. I don't think we need to restart, at least at this point. Midnight Stranger is up to $300 plus. That has nothing to do with Willy Beamish, but it's good to know. You know, before though we go to break, I think there's one thing that we could take a look at. We seem to be okay from what you've seen in the walkthrough. All right, so that's good. So we won't need to restart. We can just continue on from our saved game if it turns out that we made a mistake. So earlier in the stream, I think that we noticed that this was up. The next game in the DOS archive, Aldo's Adventure. Let's see what this is. Aldo's Adventure from 1987. It's published by Yahoo Software. You're Aldo, who for some reason looks like Mario. Your mission is to successfully reach the upper levels and obtain the treasure chest. However, beware of the falling barrels that inhibit your progress. So, I mean, this sounds like a completely original concept for a video game. The reviews, let's see, Emma F. says, like, so is Waldo like Aldo's version of Wario? Is Waldo a thief like Wario? Is that he hides everywhere? Dosh, you're raising more questions than you're answering. I like this idea that Waldo is actually the Wah version of Aldo. It's just that no one is aware of the existence of Aldo, so no one realizes Waldo's nefarious actual intent. Taffy Laffy says that Aldo from Aldo's Adventure made it in Smash Brothers. Yeah, I do not keep up with the Smash Brothers characters, so it's good to know that Aldo is getting representation. The Waldo fans are being served. Gaming Trash says no good. Come far, but fall through floor. I think fail of platform. Why, Aldo? Exactly. Why, Aldo? Why is this happening? And Garagigigigigi says bootleg Donkey Kong plays not Mario in a silky smooth 60fps knockoff of the classic arcade Donkey Kong, still better than 3D Lemmings. Well, I hope it's better than 3D Lemmings. I mean, 3D Lemmings is kind of the bottom. So let's see what Aldo has to give us. It's Aldo's Adventure. Dave and Ben Ipak made it. They made this, so let's do... Okay, let's look at the instructions. We need to get to the treasure chest. There's score, there are controls, and slow motion is a problem. We might have to slow the processor down if my processor is not fast enough to update all 8 barrels. So I don't know if my computer is strong enough to do this. Anyway, here's Aldo. So this is a completely original game concept. We're on Easy Street. No audio in the game. It's kind of like The Witness, in where there's no music in The Witness, because it increases the immersion of being in the environment, you know? The silence is deafening. Aldo, you can do it. You can get to the treasure chest up there without being murdered by barrels. I believe in you. Aldo, I know you can do it. If only these barrels would stop falling down from the sky. Where are these barrels coming from? Like, I don't see anyone actually throwing the barrels. There's no Donkey Kong or anything. I did it. And now we're on Long Island. This is what Long Island looks like, it's true. Can I jump over this? I can. Henry X, you think this is enough already? I mean, Aldo, he has ambitions. He's going places. He wants to get all these treasure chests and all of these bags of money. Who are you to tell Aldo that you've had enough of him? This is Aldo's life you're talking about. This is who he is. This is what he does. Oh no, Aldo. Aldo suffered a concussion when the barrel fell on him. Aldo just is, he's back up. He has heart, he has intestinal fortitude, but he might want to get that head looked at. is this better or worse than X-Blig? I mean, this is about on par... Oh, no. This is about on par of some of the things that I've seen on X-Blig. I don't know if I would say this is better or worse. This strikes me as something that we would have seen from 3T Games if they were making games for DOS. This seems like a 3T joint. Aldo was ahead of his time. It's true. Think about how many games have been inspired from Aldo. Think about how floaty are the controls. The controls are tight. The controls do what you need them to do. Aldo responds to your commands. This looks like an Action 52 game. Well, it is action-packed. Oh man, look at me redrawing over the lives on the top of the screen. Those lives are not refreshing. Oh no, I fell in a barrel, and now Aldo died. Aldo, though, does not give up. He is resilient, he has willpower. This is a quality production. I mean, it is... It's playable, at least. It's that. I'm not having any trouble with the controls. The game plays smoothly enough. Almost there. We've almost done it. But we can't rush into this. We have to make sure that no barrel is going to come out. Oh no, Aldo! Aldo! Well, that's probably enough for Aldo's adventures. I think Aldo is going to have to admit defeat. I think that he is just not going to be able to overcome this. We're going to have to exit. And the world goes blank for Aldo. Okay, yes, there we go. We are back in DOS. Aldo, we will always remember you. We will keep you in our thoughts, Aldo. You know, you have Aldo, and you have someone like Mario, and Mario went on to great things. He went on to fame and fortune. And Aldo, who started from the same humble beginnings, well, he was never heard from again. It's sad to think about people who just live and die, and no one even knows that they even existed. Because when people are gone, the only place they exist are our thoughts. So let's remember Aldo, and let's remember what could have been. Good night, Aldo. Good night. I guess we're going to take a little break, a little intermission, and then we'll be back to continue on with some Sin and Punishment. I'll see you in 10 minutes.
So quiet.
Okay, now my microphone is better. All right, time to get back to some Sin and Punishment, and let me just... Yep, all right, get the Wiimotes in hand, the Wiimote and the Nunchuck. We're going to start file number one. We left off on level 5, and we're going to continue. We were on the boss, and I was having a lot of trouble on this boss. So we'll see if we do any better tonight, do any better this time. Make sure I keep perfectly quiet while playing. It's true. I need to not talk at all. Also, I would consider that playing the game like this is probably not the best, since it's been like 3 weeks or something since I played it last. I don't really remember too much on how to play it, so this is probably not going to go very well. I just remember that. I was on this boss, which was a combination of the two of the bosses that we have played on this level. And I was reading a few tips from GameFAQs.com. You might have heard of it. On this boss, it suggests destroying one of the shoulders, but maybe not the other shoulder, because he starts a different attack if you do that. And maybe it's just better. To stick to destroying one of the shoulders and not doing the other one. Right, so I think I'm just going to have to get reacclimated to how the game plays for a couple minutes here. Well, at least I got it down to its final health bar. Someone asking at the beginning, could I choose to play as the guy or the girl? Yeah, you can choose to play as either one of them, and I believe that they are slightly different in how they play. I think it's their charging attack that differs. Like that big charge attack I do. Hold on, let me try to do it. This one? Like, I think that's different with the other character. All right, that's one shoulder. So that does cut down on that, on some of the attacks he's doing. Like this one, he only has the one beam coming at me this time. But like I said, the thing I read talked about how when both shoulders are destroyed, he starts doing some really fast attacks. And yeah, I remember that last time. He did some new attacks when both shoulders were destroyed. But apparently you don't have to actually destroy the shoulders. So it might just work better if I just leave it like this and try to just kill him without him going into his second phase. Although, it won't matter if I'm having such trouble actually dodging his attacks. I'm taking a lot of damage. Oh no, was that the second shoulder? I just accidentally destroyed the second shoulder. Alright, so let's see how his attacks change. Yeah, this one's different. And now he's gonna do this? Yeah, that's the one I remember. He gets really fast and starts dashing into me. Oh, I can block the claw swipes with the sword? Alright, so when he tries that again, when he gets in for the swipes, I'll start trying to melee him. Alright, that's one down, and let's try not to hit the other shoulder. He doesn't seem to flinch at all from my big charge attack, and many of the enemies and bosses have flinched, but he does not. Oh, actually, he did back off a little bit there. Okay, alright, that blocked it. Alright, so... Oh, that destroyed the shoulder! I wasn't even aiming for that! I wonder if that just automatically gets destroyed if I get him this low on health. Tried to hit those back. Didn't seem to be working. How hard is it to not destroy either shoulder? Yeah, I could try to just not destroy the shoulders at all. I could try that idea. Okay, yeah, the Destroyer's shoulder, even though I'm not even aiming for it. The size of that blast, the super blast, I guess, is enough. Even if I'm not aiming directly at it. What? Oh, okay, he did that anyway. Even though one of the shoulders is still there. Well, it was almost that time. That was better than I've done before. Slowly getting there. If only I can do a little bit better of a job at not getting hit, which is, of course, the thing that I've been quite bad at doing this entire game. Wasn't able to block those hits that time. Tried to counter with the sword that time, but it didn't work. I mean, it worked the last time, so you can do it. I guess the timing just wasn't... because my timing was just off on that. Alright. Gotta focus. Gotta be serious. Gotta dodge attacks like that. Getting hit like that is why I'm dying so much. Alright, there. That destroyed both shoulders at once? Yeah, maybe I should go back to shooting one of the wings, destroy one shoulder, and then just... hopefully I don't destroy the second shoulder until we're near the end of the battle. Maybe that's how this is gonna have to go. I should also remember to dodge, like, immediately at the beginning of the fight. Because he always hits me with the same attack right at the beginning. Alright, that's the one shoulder. Thank you. I'm not doing well on the timing in blocking his swipes. What's happening in the background? Is Earth under attack? It's more like the monsters are sort of the immune system of the Earth, which is fighting humanity, is basically what the story is. It's basically what's going on. Oh, no, it's this one. Did not get him down to his last life bar that time. Felt like I lasted longer against him this time, but I guess I did not do anywhere as much damage. I'm not able to consistently block his swipes. It's like I'm either too early or too late with it. Timing seems kinda exact. If I blocked that one, I might have actually been able to do it, because he was very low on life. Oh, that's the second shoulder. Didn't mean to do that. Not really making any consistent progress with him. Like, sometimes I'm able to do better than other times. I know what I have to do, it's just not, I'm just not able to do it, it seems. Different. It was a bigger combo. Glancing at the chat, I noticed some people talking about Space Chem. Space Chem is really good, but really, really hard. Don't know if you can actually dodge that. Like, that's another one that I take consistent damage on when he grabs me with the tail and throws me down to the ground. I'm not seeing if you can dodge it, and or maybe melee it. Maybe you can slash the tail away. Because as it is, when he starts doing that, I can count on taking a consistent amount of damage in that part of the fight. I have to assume there's a way to actually avoid that. Thank you. think I actually hit him in the face that time with the sword. My timing is just wrong. It's just wrong. And I can't figure out what the right timing is. Can melee the tail. Alright, so that is something that you can do. And I destroyed the second wing, and that is a mistake. Nope, got me on that pass. Alright, so the tail can be meleed, but like with everything else, I'm not really sure what the timing is on that melee. And it looks like that the thing to do when he's dashing at you... Oh, GameFAQ says you can melee early to stop the claw attack. Yeah, I've been doing that. kind of destroyed both wings. Not sure if just dodging that one is enough, or if maybe you have to get him with sword as he comes in, because he kept doing it, so maybe just dodging is not what you need to do. Too early on that. It might be worthwhile to stop doing charge shots when he's under 500 to avoid blowing up the wing. Yeah, maybe. It seems that it is the charge shots is the thing that's destroying the other wing. Maybe if I don't do it, maybe I can avoid that one from being destroyed. The big problem that I really have to solve is timing, like when I'm doing the melee shots to avoid his slashes or the tail whip. I'm taking so much damage just because most of the time I'm not able to get that.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Under 500, that wing does get destroyed. Yeah, stop doing charge shots when doing it is going to put him under 500 and see if that wing survives for the rest of the fight. Or maybe it's just inevitable for it to be destroyed. All right. So yeah, it just came down to being able to melee his slashes and his tail, and that gave me enough health to actually get through it. Alright, now we have a giant catbird friend, and he's going to take us to Mount Fuji, which is the home of the villains. That's their base, so I guess we're going there on our catbird.
There's Mount Fuji. Looks like they have an entire army guarding it.
The place looks like a fortress.
let us off here, big guy. Thanks.
He didn't have to let us off. I mean, we could have just stayed on him, and, like, this could have been, like, Panzer Dragoon. I wouldn't have mind if that's what the game turned into right now. Anyway, I guess this is as good a time as any to just go over the plot and make sure that we understand what's happening here, is that the villains, they want to get our friend Kachi, and we're trying to stop that from happening, so we're fighting the villains, and the villains told us to come to Mount Fuji, because that's where they are, so I guess we figure that since we have nothing else to do, we are just going to... We're just going to go to Mount Fuji and just fight them directly, because why not? That sounds like a plan. I cannot even see what's happening down there. It's just like a whole bunch of colors and glowing lights. Is Mount Fuji a currently active volcano? I saw someone ask. Well, clearly, it is in the world of Sin and Punishment, in which the power and fury and willpower of Japan is contained inside the volcano. Someone's friend of Yenkin saying no giant lakes of lava within Mount Fuji. I think that's just probably propaganda, and this game is an accurate portrayal of what it's like to enter the volcano. There's, like, a lot of robots in it. A lot of machinery. It's the base of something. I mean, I kind of forget what the story is. Like, I read a recap that went over who exactly these characters are and what it is they're doing and what it is they want, but honestly, I don't remember any of it. And the game has not actually really addressed any of it itself. I don't know if it will by the end. Yeah. This game has a very soft look to it. I mean, it looks nice, but honestly, when there's a lot of stuff on the screen, like, everything just looks like a lot of colored lights. It's kind of hard to grasp what it is you're seeing. Yes, I should not dunk myself in the lava. Lava is hot. I don't know if you know this, but lava is hot, and it hurts to touch it. All right, at least we're starting from here. Ah, it is a lava submarine. Doesn't seem like that would have much of a range of motion. The only place it could go is inside the volcano. You don't really need an entire submarine. But who am I to question the evil organization that we're fighting? They seem to know what they're doing. Are those guns coming back? Looks like they are. Oh, just ran right into that. Does this game have any relation to Space Harrier? No, I don't think any of the people from Treasure had worked on Space Harrier, and the series itself is not related to it. But, I mean, you can see that the actual gameplay... Oh, back from the beginning of this, huh? All right. The actual gameplay does certainly look like it. The game does seem to be becoming more stricter with its checkpointing recently. Like, at the beginning of the game, it was pretty generous with that stuff. But I guess that's coming to an end. Yes, I have to be hardcore now. Hardcore skills. Gotta remember that this is all about esports. It's all about the thrill of competition. It's all about being the best. And that's why it's a good thing that I put iodine on that cut on my finger so my Nintari Wii skills will not decline. Alright, we got to the boss. Okay. I'm seeing something. I'm not sure what it is I'm looking at right now. There's something on the screen right now. I can confirm that. There are images and lights being displayed. Do you think the villains, like, predicted that they would probably have a battle submarine in their lava base? Because you wouldn't think that they... When you think about a battle submarine, you think about, you know, it's traveling the oceans and stuff. You don't think there would be much of a need for it in a volcano. Alright, I guess, are we heading into the base now? The base is full of lava, too? Think you'd want to keep... And there's, like, lava rock bugs they're using for transportation? That's pretty cool. Oh, really? Okay. Let's dodge the buildings that we are flying towards for some reason. Why are we flying towards them if we're gonna get hurt by touching them? We should probably just not fly towards them. I like the lava-based wildlife that they have here. Just like wildlife that naturally grows in lava-based environments. All right, just. Felt that maybe I should sword that thing, and it turned out that yes, I should. Do I sword this when it charges? Because it looks like it's going to charge. Alright, I blasted before it could do that. Okay, yes. They just go flying when you do that. And they work like missiles that you can fling them towards the enemies. I can only assume that we're going to be seeing Anakin and Obi-Wan fighting above us somewhere. They're not going to see us or pay attention to what they're doing, but I'm guessing that, you know, we'll see them doing their thing. All right.
This train will take us to the heart of the base. What the heck is that?
This guy's tough.
Our shots bounce right off it. Okay, then. Let's see how he likes this. This train's really moving. I'll be blown away if I stay in the air for too long.
Oh, that's what I need. Okay, so what should I be doing? I can see him coming up behind me. Oh, and I died, so okay. So apparently there is some kind of new mechanic in this, aside from health. I should listen to the game. I should, instead of not paying attention to it.
This train's really moving. I'll be blown away if I stay in the air for too long.
Oh, okay. So it is being entirely literal that I should not fly. Okay. Look, it takes a few times before it gets drilled into my head. The game is about flying, so I don't know, maybe it's not a great idea to just take that mechanic away for a boss fight? I don't know. Well, whatever. Okay, we'll do this. Alright, should sword, like the sheeps? Is that what's coming at me? Okay, so I'm not really doing anything right now. I thought I had to figure something out. No, it's just, oop, no, get back down. It's nothing like that. I just have to stay on the ground and then survive. That's all that's happening here. The train is just literally going in a circle? Yeah, I guess it is. I guess this train's not actually going anywhere. Whoops.
Thank you.
Oh. It's an interesting boss mechanic. It does get kind of chaotic. Why are there guard tower train cars littering the track? Well, in case the base gets attacked and they need to use their very strange working train system that have like animals running all over it, and just like it's a system that goes just around in a circle, around and around, and with levers everywhere to disconnect the train cars in case there are large monsters that are chasing you on the track. Everything has a purpose, a reason for being. Train cars, the ultimate weapon.
It's a baby. That keeper was a mom.
Aw, man. Now I feel kind of bad for the little guy.
Isa!
Kachi! Kachi!
Extremely accurate crane, and it is... Okay, it is operating the crane. All right. Not really sure what I'm doing. I'm raising up these platforms, but why? Oh, the lava is getting higher. Didn't catch that. Why are the robots not attacking the armadillo? Because that's, you know, that's its end. Like, that's an enemy. Like, the humans and the robots do not like these things. They're apparently just ignoring it, though. I'm thinking that's probably enough for tonight. At least we got past the cat bird in the fifth level, and we're getting through the sixth level, even though we didn't complete it. We're fighting a baby armadillo. I don't know if this is the boss of the level or if there are more bosses. But I think that maybe that's enough sin and punishment for tonight. We're on level number 6, out of 7. So I guess next time we'll beat level 6. It didn't seem like there was, like, any big obstacles here. Even though I'm dying a few times, it doesn't seem like this is anything that is going to stop us for a while. And then we'll get to level 7, which I'm sure will be a good deal harder. And we'll see what happens when we get to 7 and fight the final bosses and how that gets. I'm guessing it's going to get real hard. Okay, we made some progress in Sin and Punishment, we, made some progress in Willy Beamish, and we took Aldo's adventures into our hearts. We'll always remember Aldo, and, we will also keep track of, Jeff Green's Kickstarter and see how Midnight Stranger does. Like I said, I hope he makes it, but crowdfunding is not an easy thing if you don't have a pre-existing audience. So I hope that they're working on trying to get something happening in that respect. But I think this is probably the time to say goodnight. It's time to say goodnight, and it's time to say goodbye, and it's time to say that I'll see you next week. So what's happening this coming week? There'll be another Witness video. I hope you're enjoying those. I like the Witness so far. I think it's fun. I'm interested in what it's doing. So I'm going to continue on with those. Also this week, there'll be a demo friend. Could be one of two things as to what it could be. There's another Android game that I'm looking at that might do one, as well as a 3DS demo. I'm thinking about which one I might want to do. There are some new XBLIGs that are out, but like I think there are 3 new XBLIGs since the last video I did, and I usually do wait until at least there are 4 games before I do a video of that. So there are a few options. I'm continuing preparing for the next LP, which is not The Witness. The Witness is something separate, but it'll be a few weeks yet before we start the next LP. So yeah, doing a bunch of different videos, a few things. Mib is asking, is The Witness similar to The Talos Principle? No, not really. They're similar in terms of genre. They're both first-person puzzle games. They're similar in that respect, but they're very different in how they do it. I would not consider these to be actually the same types of games at all. Even though a lot of people do compare them, I don't think that these are the same type of thing. There's a lot of difference in the nuance in how Talos and Witness do their puzzle thing. But I really like Talos, and I really like Witness so far. I don't know if I will like Witness as much as I liked Talos. Let's see, Just Mib saying, sadly, The Witness is not The Talos Principle 2. And it's true. This is not The Talos Principle 2. Don't expect it to be. Talos Principle was heavy on narrative, heavy on storyline, and heavy on writing, especially in Road to Gehenna. The writing in that is very good and actually very funny. That expansion, I think, is some of the best comedic writing I've seen in a video game. Which is interesting, the same year that Undertale came out, even counting that. The writing in Talos and the expansion is fantastic. Witness doesn't have writing, you know, it doesn't really have that. It's purely puzzles, purely exploration, and purely about learning, where Talos really is extensively about its story. So anyway, yeah, I really like The Witness, but it is not Talos, and you should not expect it to be Talos. I don't know what my opinion will be on The Witness when it's done, when we're finished, but I like it so far. I'm really enjoying it, but it's a different thing. It is a very different thing. But anyway, I think that's going to be it for the stream. I think it's going to be it for tonight. I think that's going to be it for the week. I'm happy that you came to watch me play video games, as we do. I hope that you have a good coming week. I hope that you're here, and we'll get together again next week for more Beamish. We'll definitely do that. We'll continue on with the DOS archive. My controller has been disconnected. In a way, all of our controllers are disconnected. All of our control methods have been set to the GCN controller. You know, I never even thought about using that as a controller for this game. I wonder if I should try that. I didn't even think about doing that. Be interesting to see how that plays. But yes, more DOS next time as we continue on with the A's. Someone mentioned airports, but we are not doing airports. We are heading in more like into the ALs is where we're going. And then more Sin and Punishment. We'll see if we can finish the game, or if not, maybe the week after. So have a good night, everyone. Have a good week. I'll see you next time.